attorney here in Wyandotte County, and I brought my daughter up here with me, Lily. She's my third daughter. The rest of my children are over here working my wife. I'm running because when I look at them, a question is asked. And that question is, am I doing everything in my power to make sure that this community is safe for my babies? I grew up here my entire life. And my entire life, this has been known as crime time. And quite frankly, I'm tired of it. I'm tired of it because we can do better, we deserve better. I am running for a better Wyandotte County. I'm running for a safer Wyandotte County. I'm running because I love this county. My parents have pastored here in the inner city for 30 years. I have had to bury some of the victims of those of ridiculous crimes. I've had to minister to those who have gone through the court system. I prosecuted in Jackson County. I've been a defense lawyer for the last 6 years with my lovely wife, who's a family law attorney and a great mother. She's out of here, but I did say it. And so I have diversity of experience so that we can determine what is the best route to go for Wyandotte County. The DA's office deals with the abused and neglected children. I practice as a guardian at Lido as a parent's attorney, and so I know how KBC, DCF, and all of that is supposed to work. What I'm asking for you to do is to look at my website, do3forda.com. I want to make it clear. I interned in the current DA's office. I have no ill will toward the DA's office. I am running for a better Wyandotte. And at the end of the day, if we do not have a safer Wyandotte, then people die. People are released when they shouldn't be. And our police officers who put their lives on the line, who go out here to investigate, to take these criminals down, deserve someone in place who's going to finish the job in the courtroom and get the convictions. Right now, we have the lowest conviction rate in the state of Kansas for similarly situated sons. Our conviction rate is 60%. That means 40% of the cases that we take to trial, we lose. Something has to change. And I'm telling you that a vote for Dupree is a vote for your babies, it's a vote for your future, and it's a vote for Wyandotte County. God bless you.
Fuck yeah, Bernie. Fuck yeah. That's what we're doing. That's what we're here for.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Jerry Norman, and I am the district attorney. District attorney since 2005. What Mr. Dupree says is that we have only a 60% conviction rate is not true. We convict a much higher percentage than that.
Follow me.
We also try the second most number of cases in the state. Okay. We have a very high violent crime rate in our county. I have a very experienced staff that I've put together, and my staff is one of the most experienced in the state of Kansas. I myself have tried well over 200 jury trials, well over 45 homicide cases. My opponent can't come anywhere near that. Over the years, we have worked very well with the police department, with all of law enforcement in Wyandotte County. The district attorney is the chief law enforcement officer of the county. I am not a politician. I am not a reverend. I'm a law enforcement officer, and that's what I will continue to do in serving you in Wyandotte County. It's great to see so many people here at caucus today. I'm really surprised. It's a very large turnout. It's great that I think everybody is here to take part in a democratic process. I ask that you enjoy that process today, and I ask that you get out to the polls in August and vote for Gorman for DA.
Thank you.
let's keep going up there. Let's go.
Yo, Brad, right. Check this out.
We have a couple of judge candidates. I didn't know if Courtney made it back yet or not. I don't believe she did. But Courtney Ketzke is running for judge, and Renee Henry. I'd like to invite Renee Henry up to tell you a little bit about herself.
Soon. You'll see.
How's everybody doing today?
Good. About to get better.
I'm not running into anything, so can I get a box of that? This is the second biggest. I've been coming to Coxville since 1972, before I was old enough to vote. And this is the second biggest caucus in our Senate district here we've ever had. I do want to say that the previous one was when we filled up the Woodlands and Barack Obama pretty much dominated that caucus. So and 12 years ago this month, we started the Wyandotte County Third Saturday Democratic Breakfast. And it's moved to various places, and we meet at the dot spot now, 8123 parallel. Is that a hint for the dot spot? Good food, good place to live, and so my good Democrats. So I took the names and addresses and phone numbers of people who wanted to get involved, and I want to get you on my email list. And
93.
A couple of them got lost over here, so if I can get my notebook back.
Hey, what's up, Kyle?
Great. And I'll get you involved and keep you informed of what's going on in Wyandotte County Democrats and Democratic-oriented events. Also, I'd like to acknowledge Barbara Eichard, who is the chair of the African-American Democratic Caucus of Wyandotte County. Barbara, stand up, sir.
Me too.
If you're interested in getting involved in the African American Caucus, please see her today. And also, I see it quite a few. I used to be a young Democrat. Raise your hand if you were ever a member of the Kansas Young Democrats, the Young Democrats of Wyandotte County. The Bill County Reardon over here, Tom Groening was president one time. Bill Hutton, I've known him since about that time. He was an active Young Democrat. Now, how many people here are under 35, under the age of 35? You should have the most active Young Democrat chapter in the state. And I think we need to get that chapter organized for the Young Democrats. So if you're under 35, you can be involved in the Young Democrat organization. Can I get some amens that you'll get one organized?
Amen. Yeah, we're on the other side.
With that, let me turn it back.
Standing room only on this side.
I'm selling for a dollar piece, and that's not even the cost of getting them printed.
There, America has a coke problem, and Kansas has a coke problem. Tom Jordan's back there showing it off. So if you would like to help out, that helps it out. Thank you very much.
Coke problem. Not yet. Waiting on the 5G.
Right. We are almost to where we all want to be. I am going to skip ahead a little bit here. The state party has asked us to pass the hat, as we traditionally do at most Democratic events, and I have the hat. So I'm going to start it on the Bernie side. I'll see if you're nice and cool. So come on the Bernie side. And Judge Caitlin first. Donation. It's a way to start off. Thank you very much. This money goes to the KDP and helps us fight the Democrats all year long. Thank you.
Pass the hat. Pass it. Pass it.
Yeah, I'm sure that's clear. We're fighting for Democrats.
That's all it is.
We are fighting for Democrats. I didn't bother mentioning that party's name.
Not sure.
Okay. So now we're going to have the candidate representative speech. We're going to do a brief overview of the delegate process. I'm going to have Mickey come up and start with Bernie's, and then I'm going to have Dick Petro with Hillary. And then we're going to form our preference groups, which we're already in for the most part. The undeclareds are back there. So these speeches are going to help you all kind of understand where you may or may not need to go. And at that point, we will announce the viability. At that point, we'll take an initial count and announce viability, and then we'll announce for a realignment of preference groups, and then we'll take a final one. So, without further ado, Mickey.
Since then, I have lived here in Kansas City since 1991, and when my husband and I came back, we proudly chose the dot as where we wanted to raise our family.
Democrat.
Since the meantime, I've worn several different hats, but my most important job has and always will be as a mother and a wife. My husband Paul and I have a 12-year-old daughter named Trinity. If we're friends on Facebook, that's pretty much all you see photos of. She is a sixth grader at Arrowhead Middle School, and it's in that capacity as a mom that I want to share with you my feelings why Bernie Sanders is the only candidate for the Democratic nomination. Dr. Seuss is a favorite non-haps, and when I think of Bernie, I think of Courtney Elephant and Gordon Here's the Who. Ever since Bernie Sanders has joined our political landscape, he has been a pillar of integrity. There has never been any doubt where he stood on an issue or who he truly represented. Bernie has meant what he said, and he said what he meant, and Bernie is faithful
100%.
Whether fighting in the civil rights movement in the 60s with the March on Washington, or being working with CORE in Chicago, helping minorities get fair housing. Horton, just like Bernie, a person is a person no matter how small. And Bernie Sanders has always, from the beginning, supported LGBT concerns, and it has always, since day one, been a plank of his platform. He has diligently worked for the elimination of all discriminatory laws pertaining to a person's sexuality. Because Bernie knows that a person's a person, no matter how small. Bernie Sanders has also been a champion of the working class. He's fought for a decent living wage and equal pay for everyone. jobs here in the U.S., and he has challenged bad trade deals like NAFTA. And as our next president, he will continue to do so, because Bernie has said what he meant, and he meant what he said, and Bernie is faithful 100%. As shown in his historic speech from 1976, which is now just known as the speech, he was speaking to labor unions. And Senator Sanders has always stood with labor and trade unions. His message then was that corporations were too powerful and that the workers, quite frankly, were getting screwed. Both major parties were, even then, beholden to the big bosses. Ironically, it's the same message over 40 years later. Remember, because what Bernie has meant is what he said, and he said what he meant. And Bernie is faithful 100%. Senator Sanders introduced the Too Big to Fail, Too Big to Exist Act of 2015. Legislation that would direct the government to compile a list of systematically imported financial institutions and then direct the Secretary of the Treasury to break up those institutions within 1 year, banning them from receiving all special help from the Federal Reserve. Once again, Bernie has said what he meant, and he meant what he said. And Bernie is faithful 100%. Bernie has supported our veterans, even serving as the chair of the House Services Committee. He believes just as planes and tanks and guns are across the war, so are those men and women who go out and valiantly fight to defend our country, and not forgetting at all their families who are just as important. Because Bernie believes that a person is a person, no matter how small. Senator Sanders introduced legislation to lift the cap on Social Security so that everyone who makes over $250,000 a year pays the same percentage of income into Social Security as the middle class and working families. Everyone should pay a fair share. More seniors out of poverty. And Bernie keeps showing us, year after year, word and by deed, a person is a person no matter how small. If America is serious about reforming the tax code and rebuilding the middle class, we have got to demand that the wealthiest Americans and the largest corporations pay their fair share in taxes. Senator Sanders' tax reform will close loopholes that benefit the wealthy and well-connected, making tax code more progressive and establish tax on Wall Street speculators whose greed and recklessness nearly destroyed our economy 7 years ago. Bernie has meant what he said, and he said what he's meant. Bernie is faithful 100%. So as the mayor of Hoonville said, this is our town's darkest hour. It's the time for all Americans who have blood that is red to come to the aid of their country. We have got to make noises in greater mass. So open your mouths, for every voice counts. Because a person's a person, no matter how small. To those of you here in this room, now and at this hour, you have the choice, and you have the power. In my best word voice, I say unto you, stand with us as Bernie stands up for you. Thank you.